Good morning, children, and welcome to my new class. So today we'll be starting the next chapter, which is a poem, In the Bazaars of Hyderabad by Sarojini Naidu. You all must be knowing who Sarojini Naidu is, a very famous poet, very famous writer of our country. So she has written this beautiful poem, In the Bazaars of Hyderabad. Now what this poem is about? This poem is basically about a fair where the poet visits and she sees different kind of people selling different kind of things. And she is curious to know what everybody is selling and what importance it holds. So let us move on and read. So here, what do you sell, O ye merchants? Richly your wares are displayed. Now here, the poet is curious when she looks at the merchant and she asks, what do you sell, O ye merchants? Richly your wares, wares means accessories, the things, are displayed, are put over there. Turbans of crimson and silver. So crimson and silver tell us about the colors, and turban is a long piece of cloth which is worn round, worn round the head by the men. The turbans of crimson and silver are the colors. Tunics of purple brocade. Brocade is a kind of a cloth material. The tunics which are made up of purple brocade. Mirrors with panels of amber. Now amber is a kind of a material. So mirrors are there, beautiful mirrors are there which have panels. That is the boundaries which are made up of amber. Daggers. Dagger is a kind of a knife with handles of jade. Jade is also another material. So here when she looks at all those things, she is curious and she asks the merchant, what do you sell, O ye merchant? So let us move on. Now, what does she say next? What do you weigh, O ye vendors? Now who are vendors? Vendors are the people who move from one place to another to sell their thing. So she is asking, what do you weigh? Weigh means, what do you weight and sell? Saffron and lentil and rice. So saffron, you all know what is saffron. It's a very expensive kind of a spice, you can say. Lentil, the dals which we talk about, and rice. What do you grind, O ye maidens? Maidens means the young girls who are sitting there. She asks, what do you grind? Sandalwood, henna and spice. So the maidens are grinding sandalwood, henna and spice. What do you call, O ye peddlers? Peddlers are also like vendors only. Peddlers are the people who carry a lot of things and they keep, go on from one street to another street calling out and selling. So what do you call? Call means they shout and they call people to buy things. So what are the peddlers selling? Chessmen and ivory dye. What is ivory? Ivory is made up of elephant tooth. So chessmen and ivory dye. I hope it is clear till here. Let us move on. What do you make, O ye goldsmiths? Now she wants to know what the goldsmiths are making. Wristlet and anklet and ring. So these are the accessories which are worn by the people. Bells for the feet of blue pigeons. They also make bells for the feet of blue pigeons. Frail as a dragonfly's wing. Frail means very weak, which will break even if you touch it. Frail means very weak and which can be broken down just by touching it. As a dragonfly's wing, you must have seen a dragonfly, its wings are so thin, so they are frail. Girdles of gold for dancers. Now what are girdles? See here, for your convenience, they have also given here the word. See, here everything is given. Girdles means the belts or the cords worn around the waist. So girdles of gold for dancers. You must have seen that the dancers, they put some belt kind of a thing over their waist. Scabbards of gold for the king. Now what is a scabbard? Scabbard is a case to cover the sword in which they put their sword. So So, what do the goldsmiths prepare? They prepare so many things: wristlets, anklets, and rings. And they also make bells for the feet of blue pigeons, which are very light, very weak. Then they make girdles of gold for dancers and scabbards of gold for the king. Next, what do you cry? Oh, ye fruit men. Now, again, there are fruit men over there. So she's saying, what do you cry? Now, here, cry does not mean cry. Cry here means shout, when they shout and ask people to come and buy things from them. Citron, pomegranate, and plum. So, citron is a kind of a large lemon, you all know. Pomegranate and plum. What do you play? Oh, musicians. Now, she comes across the musicians who are playing something. So, she asks them, what do you play? Oh, musician. So, what do they say? They play sitar, sarangi, and drum. What do you chant? What do you mean by chant? Chant means to repeat and to recite something. So, what do you chant? Oh, magicians. So, see, she asks the magicians, what are you chanting? What are you repeating again and again? So, the magicians say, spells of yawns to come. Spell means a magical word. So, spell for yawns to come. You can see the meaning here. It means that magic that will work for a long time. Yawns means a very long time. What do you weave? Oh, ye flower girls. Now, flower girls are the young girls who have a lot of flowers in the basket and they are weaving it with tassels of azure and thread. Now, tassels means here the threads, the silk threads of azure and red. So, what do the girls say? They're making crowns for the brow of the bridegroom, chaplets to garland his head. Chaplets means the garland. And sheets of white blossoms, new garnered, means fresh, just picked white flowers to make sheets of flowers to perfume the sleep of the dead. It means that some sheets which are made up of white flowers to cover the dead people. You must have seen. So here the flower girls tell that they are preparing so many things with the flowers which are used in the happy times as well as in the sad. So these are all the things which the poet comes across when she goes to the bazaar of Hyderabad. I hope this is clear to you and you'll all go through it. Go through the poem nicely, the word meanings are given, and then in my Zoom class, we'll be discussing the questions. So have a nice day and keep learning.